Which of these two functions is faster? And how much faster? Hi, my name is Huani. You may have a hunch which of these functions are faster, but today we're going to look at how we can get some empirical evidence using Go's benchmarking tools. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to convert a UInt32 into a hex string using the format package and surround that with a benchmark. The next thing we're going to do is analyze the results of that benchmark and explore the tools a little bit. And then finally, we're going to write another benchmark for the string convert package and see how it compares against the formatting package. So let's get started with Go mod init, and I'm going to call this tutorial/benchy. And then we're going to create a file called benchy_test.go and give it the package name benchy. And now we can define a benchmark. So I'm going to go with func benchmark_format hex, and it's going to take a single argument, which will be this b of type testing.b. Inside here, we'll define a for loop for I is equal to 0, I is less than b.n, I plus plus, and then inside here we can write our benchmark code. So basically, the benchmark tooling expects a for loop like this and will actually pass in the number of times to run the benchmark for gathering its metrics. So in here I'm going to say if format.string printf for a string of a hex, and we're going to pass in 0x12345678, and we're going to say if this does not equal 12345678, then we're going to call b.fail because something went wrong. So there's our benchmark. Now, something that you might occasionally see is a call to b.resetTimer before the for loop. And the reason for that is that sometimes benchmarks have some setup code here, and we want to not count that setup code as part of our benchmark metrics. In this case, we don't have any setup code, so I'm going to omit that resetTimer call. So let's jump into the terminal. We can run our benchmark with go test-bench equals to dot, where dot runs all the benchmarks in the package. We could alternatively specify a particular benchmark if we wanted to. And now the tool's printed out which operating system we're running, the architecture that it's running on, and the package, as well as the results from our format hex benchmark. So this number here is the number of times that the internals of this for loop was run, and here it tells us how long it took to execute. In this case, 47 nanoseconds. We can also add another flag with go test-bench equals dot and then bench mem. And this is going to tell us a little bit more information, like how many bytes were allocated and how many allocations per operation there were. In this case, it was a single string, which is 8 bytes long. Next, we're going to go back into our benchmark code, and we're going to copy and paste this format hex and replace it with string convert. And inside here, we can delete our call to format.stringprintf and replace it with stringconvert.formatUint. And this is going to take two arguments. The first is going to be the unsigned integer to format, and then the second is the base, and for hexadecimals, that's base 16. So now we can jump back into the terminal, and we can run go test bench again, and this time we're going to see results for both benchmarks. So what we can see here is that benchmark format hex takes 48 nanoseconds per operation, but the string convert function only takes 16 nanoseconds, so it's about 3 times faster. Benchmarking provides empirical evidence that the improvements that you're making to your code base have a real performance impact. I've been Huani Bryson. Happy benchmarking, and I'll see you later.